Nintendo Switch Lite. What's going on with this one? I just checked the port. It does look like it's had a little bit of wear and tear, but it's not doesn't look compromised. So what we're going to do is we're going to perform a quick power test. Let me switch you to hand cam here. We're watching the meter on the left-hand side. I just want to see what this switch is doing. And it's sitting at a 0.12. Right away, this would lead me to believe probably a PMIC issue, but we won't really know until we get it open, get it cracked open, and take a look. So that's what we'll do. Okay, we have the board out of the housing, and we're ready to do some testing. I just want to get straight to the testing. I don't believe anything is touching in the port. I mean, it could be, but I don't think so at this moment. We'll switch you to microscope so you can follow along. We're going to go straight to the N92T36. We'll use the port as ground. Let's start testing. Okay, so this line on this capacitor going to the chip is short, and it should not be. Continue checking. And we have another line that's short. It should not be. And that one's short, and it should not be. And that one's short, and it should not be. This thing's short everywhere. Just about. Okay, so all these capacitors here are short. This one is here short. The lines going to the chip. Now there is one capacitor here with two lines going. One side will always be ground on the capacitor, but in the rest of these cases, the line going to the chip should not be shorted, and we have lots of shortage. These three here, and this guy here. So N92T36 is definitely bad. We kind of suspected that from the current draw. Check our BQ24193, and it appears to be okay. Very good. Okay, so we're gonna go straight after the N92T36. All right, before we begin and while I set up my equipment, we will throw up our expected temperatures for this job. As always, these temperatures are subject to change, but they don't typically change very much when I'm doing a switch or switch light. So I probably will not come off of them. And as always, these temperatures are brought to you by the Amazon Associate links in the description. If you click on one of those links and buy one of those pieces of equipment or buy anything during that session, it doesn't have to be one of those pieces of equipment. A small portion of that purchase will go to supporting the channel and will not cost you an extra dime. Be much appreciated. Switch you back to microscope. Let's pull this bad N92T36. Throw the new one on, then we'll test. I can always pull it if we still have shorts. Like a work where the board is warm. Let the surface tension do its job. Pull the heat. Let it dry a little bit. Push down. Re-wet everything. Knock the cap. Check our work. Okay. Strangely, one of our connectors fell off. I will have to put that back on. Never had that happen before. Other than the additional work, everything looks all right. Let's test, make sure our shorts have been relieved. And no shorts remain. Excellent. We're going to use heat under the board and fold this one back into place. I'm not going to use any flux because I don't want a bunch of flux in the connector. We should be able to do it anyway. I reworked that chip using 380 degrees and somehow I knocked out this connector. That's strange. I wasn't even at the right temperature. I'm going to say it was probably a little bit dork to begin. not sure that floated in place at all. It appears to have at least the anchors. Take a look and see how we did. Nah. Definitely not. I should at least be able to see. Hand check those and make sure, but they look like they're connected. Same for this side. Okay, solid. Solid, so our chipping and everything didn't get messed up. No, everything was alright. Alright, we're gonna do some cleanup. Okay, let's see what we're doing power wise. Looks relatively normal. And that looks relatively normal. Now check in PSU channel 2. We're going to use the OEM charger to activate. And what we want is just a steady climbing average. Seems to be hanging. There we go. Did not give it time to activate. Just a steady climbing amperage is what we want. No hanging. And that looks good to me. Excellent. Next step is going to be to put it back in the housing and make sure everything boots up and works correctly. It'll probably have to charge its own battery for a little while. There's not a great way to use my battery squid on the light because the LCD ribbon goes over the battery connector. I mean, I could probably make it work, but there's no point. I'll just let it charge and we'll go from there. So as you can see, they managed to dork something up. I may have a closer look at this ribbon cable and see if they have actually managed to dork it up, but changing the battery, they really messed this up. This was not my client's shop, by the way. This is another shop. My client's shop was the second place they took it to. Yeah, they made a nice mess of this, so. Let me see if I can clear that up and make sure it's not going to dork up that cable and make sure that cable doesn't have any holes in it or anything like that. And then we'll go from there. Okay, I went ahead and risked it, and as you can see, we're booted back up. The cable seems to have survived that damage somehow miraculously. I pulled off all the little metal shards and stuff like that, and none of them had punctured the cable. So we will continue with getting it back together, and then we'll come back and perform our tests and go from there. Okay, I have this back together enough to test and hold in the battery so it's not flip-flopping around. 0.47, full partial battery symbol. Reset. Fast charging, very good. Battery's working. Flip it around, make sure it's charging on both sides. It's fast charging on both sides, excellent. I just want to make sure all of our Joy-Cons and stuff are working. Very good. Make sure we're picking up Wi-Fi. And we're picking up our networks. This one's pretty much fixed. In summary, we had a Nintendo Switch no power, a Nintendo Switch Lite no power, pulling about 0.13 amps, 0.14 amps, steady. We pulled it apart. We tested the N92 T36. We found shorts around the N92 T36, about four of them. We changed out the N92 T36 And strangely, the LCD connector fell off while we were doing that, so got a bonus connector replacement on top of it. Put everything back together, and everything seems to be testing out for the most part. Well, if you have any questions, leave a comment in the description below, and I'll do my best to answer it, or send you somewhere that I can't answer it. I really appreciate the channel support. If you like this video, well, I think you'll like this one here. And I'll see you over there.